coming to you from Saskatchewan here. Did you know that we do a lot of different things on the Quick Dick channel here? Sometimes we even cook. That's why this week we're doing another episode of Cooking with Quick Dick.
That's right. Welcome to Cooking with Quick Dick, where you learn how to cook Saskatchewan bachelor style using the least amount of dishes and making yourself enough food for the next week.
And I guess seeing as how we have a bunch of cute little calves running around and no cows have pissed me off yet today, we're going to take a break from beef on this Cooking with Quick Dick. And today we're going to cook pork and beans. And everyone's like, Quick Dick, you mean you're just going to open a can of beans and eat it? Well, yeah, sometimes I do that, but we're going to make some real pork and beans this time.
First thing you got to do is get yourself a big-ass Canadian pork loin. Make sure it's out of the freezer and thawed in the morning. And then when you get out of bed, put it on the counter in a pan.
Damn good garlic pepper blend from Calvington, Saskatchewan. Give her a serious coat on both sides. Don't be shy with this stuff. Coat the fat. Leave the fat where it's at. Rusty Sled, made in Canada. Get it in there. And then all of the salt and everything that's in the bottom of the pan, wipe it off with this pig bastard. And now we are just gonna cover this with tin foil and we're gonna let it come up to room temperature.
Now finish your coffee, get your ass dressed and get to work.
When you come back in from feeding critters, get out your pressure cooker. Throw in a little shot of canola oil.
Make sure your canola oil says product of Canada on it, right? Because we want to support Canadian farmers, right? Right.
Get a bag of white navy beans, 900 grams.
Same rule, product of Canada because we want to support Canadian farmers, right?
Add a liter of your favorite kind of broth. I got chicken kicking around, so that's what I'm gonna use. You can use beef, you can use whatever kind of broth you want. Top on, close the vent, you dummy.
Otherwise, you'll wind up like Quick Dick and chicken broth steaming the underside of your old cupboards.
35 minutes high pressure, walk away.
Now, you must go fire up the smoker. Now, when I say fire up the smoker, I don't mean go down to Willie's Tavern on Main Street in Foam Lake and pick somebody that's having a dart and try and talk shit to him.
I just mean turn your smoker on, that's all.
Unwrap your pork loin. This thing should be room temperature right now, okay? And we are gonna take some yellow mustard. And we're just gonna let her rip on that thing.
Just brush her in there real nice, real nice.
Don't be cheap with the mustard. You know what? We knew this was gonna happen again. We knew this was gonna happen anyways. Okay, now we're taking our rusty sled, our pork rub again here, right? We're gonna get the ends, put her on thick. Don't be shy with this stuff. This is gonna make your bark. It's gonna be super tasty. Get her everywhere you can. As Belton Johnson says, get it in every nook and cranny. Look at this, you can't miss these parts. It's important. Okay, we're gonna rip this out to the smoker.
This bad boy's going on here, fat side up. A little shot of mustard, not too much, a little bit. Rusty Sled, let's go. It's your fancy meat probe. Run that into the thickest part of your loin. Do not open that lid anymore. Okay, now let's get back to work on those beans.
Get yourself some shrooms. Cut them big.
Get yourself a couple onions. Chop them up.
Make sure to cut the onion, not your fingers.
I hope you got a good dealer, because you're going to need some garlic. Now I like to chuck a little kick into mine, so I get some chipotle peppers and adobo sauce.
we're gonna make sauce.
Half cup ketchup.
Canadian ketchup with Canadian tomatoes, right?
Right.
Half a cup of pure Canadian maple syrup.
Quarter of a cup of Canadian refined brown sugar.
Quarter of a cup of molasses.
Why do they call it fancy molasses? Like, I don't understand what's so fancy about molasses. It just kind of makes a big mess most of the time. You can use fancy molasses or you don't have to be fancy. I don't care.
And then 2 tablespoons of Worcestershire, however you say it, Worcestershire sauce. Or I guess however much you got left. I gotta stop making so many Caesars, I guess. Then give that bastard a stir and dissolve all that sugar in there. That's the kind of consistency you're looking for there, okay? And just give that a little bit of a try.
Oh yeah, that's nice. Okay, beans are done, vent them off. This is actually how I sanitize all my dish rags.
We all know I only have one dish rag, okay?
Get your trusty old bean pan out of the stove. Stay in there.
Stay with me here, folks. This is gonna go fast, okay? Beans, in. Onions, chipotles, garlic, in. Sauce, in. Mushrooms, go.
Product of Canada, 796 mils, diced tomatoes, drain them. Okay, now mix all that together and you're gonna wanna act like a little bit of a cowboy. Get yourself some Cowboy Thunder. It's like a coffee rub spice. I just put this stuff on absolutely everything. I got the link in the description of this video where you can get some. Give it a heavy dusting of this stuff. It's made in Canada, it's what makes it the best. All right, to the smoker. Do not cover these.
There's a reason for it. Those beans are gonna soak up some moisture. We want the smoke to go all around in those mushrooms and tomatoes, and we want the fat off of this thing to drop down into the beans, okay?
All right, that smoker's gonna need like at least 4 hours here, so there's only one thing left for me to do, and that's to get my ass back outside to work. So why don't you take a few minutes and hear from today's Cooking with Quick Dick sponsor.
Today's episode of Cooking with Quick Dick is brought to you by QuickDickMcDick.ca.
QuickDickMcDick.ca. Why .ca? Because just like all of our merchandise, even our website is made in Canada.
We've got t-shirts and long sleeve tees.
Do you want to help save the environment? QuickDick merch can double as a shop rag because we all know that clothes are going to wind up as a shop rag at the end of their life cycle anyway. So let's save some paper towel and use a long sleeve tee instead.
Have you ever tried not using your clothes as a rag?
No, that's crazy talk.
We have got snapback trucker hats.
It's springtime. You should hang up the ear flap hat and get yourself a Quick Dick snapback trucker hat.
See, I hear you. The weather changes fast, so you're like, Quick Dick, I don't want to switch over to a snapback trucker hat yet. Well, that's why you need a Quick Dick bunny hug. Because when it starts snowing, you just pull the hood up.
Hey, not only are Quick Dick bunny hugs Canadian made, they're made heavy. They're 20 ounces. They're 80-20 cotton poly, and I chore test these bastards.
Is Quick Dick merch fire retardant?
No, but does it stand up to heat?
Well, yes, as you can see right here, if you get a little bit too close to the old infrared heater there, it doesn't spontaneously combust, and I mean, there's a second layer on this hood, so I mean, it didn't penetrate all the way through.
Maybe a guy like you should consider wearing a helmet full time.
Quick Dick helmets? That's not a bad idea, actually.
Hey, maybe it hurts when you pull a heavy one over your head and you want something that zips up, it's a little bit lighter, and you can wear it to town, maybe to a dance or something like that. Guess what? Got you covered. And you know what else?
Quick Dick merch looks better on girls.
It's true, actually. See any feet yet?
No.
And you know what else? Here at QuickDickMcDick.ca, we're not a bunch of chumps like some of these other guys that put their stuff out as Canadian products and you check the tag and it's made in China. Here at QuickDickMcDick.ca, every piece of our merchandise is proudly made in Western Canada, supporting Western Canadian jobs and Western Canadian economy.
What are you waiting for, people? Go to QuickDickMcDick.ca and make QDM outerwear a part of your world today. Or don't. Do whatever you want.
What do you think? Should we clear up the rumor mill that's churning out of control in the comment section right now?
Yeah.
Are you my girlfriend?
No.
Why?
Because you're my neighbor and you can be old enough to be my dad.
It hurts my core when you say things like that, okay? So that being considered, let's be respectful in the comments section because I am a pretty good hunter, right? And now that Quick Dick's done shamelessly promoting his merchandise, let's get back to pork and beans on Cooking with Quick Dick. And seeing as how we're all done here for the day, why don't we head on back to the house and see how that pork's doing?
First things first, I need a beer.
Oh, yes. Okay, let's go check on that pork. Oh, look how nice this is all looking. Okay, that pork I just checked is at 145 Fahrenheit. We're gonna bring it up to 150, and then we're gonna pull it and let it rest for a half hour. And these beans, we're gonna leave right here till we pull the pork, okay?
So while we're waiting on that pork, why don't we whip up some cornbread? Dry ingredients first. Cup and a quarter of cornmeal. Then we're gonna do 3/4 cup of flour, but I like to do something a little fancy with my flour.
Little trick I like to do is take some wheat that we harvest right off of the farm here, and I'll take 1/4 cup of it. I'm gonna blast that through a bullet. Look at that. Get a little bit of homemade flour there. 2 teaspoons of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of pink Himalayan salt because it makes me feel like a big man thinking that I'm eating part of the Himalayans. And then just give that bastard a stir. So now we're gonna take 8 tablespoons or 1 stick of good old Canadian butter, and we're gonna support Canadian beekeepers, and we're gonna get 1/4 cup of honey in there. And we're gonna chuck that in the nuclear oven and we're gonna melt that down. While we're waiting on that butter and honey, get yourself a couple of farm eggs from the neighbors. ⅓ cup of Canadian produced milk. Then give that just a little bit of a what fur. Let's grab that honey and butter. Ooh, zing that in there. Real nice. Real nice. Give that a little stir. Okay, now we're gonna get our dry. What goes into the dry? Give that a little stir. Get yourself a cast iron skillet and get a little piece of butter like this. We're gonna grease the inside of that skillet. Do not be cheap with the butter here, people. All right, so now we're gonna take a drink of our beer. Okay, so now that pork loin's at 150 Fahrenheit internal, why don't we go pull that sucker off the smoker?
Look at that monster.
All right, we're gonna pull our thermometer. Look at those beans. Cover it. That goes into rest. That's gonna rest for 30 minutes. These beans are gonna get covered. We're gonna put them inside of the old oven inside and just keep them warm. Okay, now we're gonna set this sucker to 375, tidy up our grill here so it's nice and ready for that skillet.
Okay, people, while that smoker's heating back up, wet mixture into the pan. Give it a little shake down, a little tap on the counter, make sure you're aware of it. Look at them bubbles coming out of there. Onto the smoker.
Top rack. 25 minutes or until a toothpick comes out clean from the inside of it.
So I'll do some dishes while I'm waiting.
Check this out, folks. Oh, look at that. See how it's starting to get nice and brown around the edges there? That's what we're looking for. I don't have a toothpick, I've just got a floss pick, but let's see what it does. This sucker's done, folks. Let's pull it before it gets overdone. Real nice.
Baked beans, look at that pork loin all done up. Now this right here is a chipotle sauce that I'm not gonna tell you how I make because that's coming to the grave with me. And then we get a nice cornbread skillet right over here. So all I gotta do now is eat it with all my friends.
And everyone's all like, Quick Dick, why do you cook so much at once? Well, the next morning you gotta be able to take all your leftovers and put it in your Tufnelware so that you've got lunch made for the next 8 days. Meal prep 101, folks.
This has been Cooking with Quick Dick, where we might not be professionals, but it still tastes pretty damn good and makes a turn.
This is Quick Dick McDick and Axel signing off, reminding you, you're going to want to make sure you know what Quick Dick means when he says, hey, you want to come over for some pork and beans? Catch you next time.